This is what I would consider the greatest book ever written in history. It's a first edition copy of Isaac Newton's Principia Mathematica. What's even more exciting is that I have here the original pre-publication manuscripts of the Principia, written in Isaac Newton's own handwriting.
The Principia spelled out for the first time the mathematical principles that govern the universe and the law of gravity that holds all matter in place.
For Newton, gravity was a force that acts on any object with mass, be it the moon, the earth, even an apple. It's the same gravitational force that keeps us stuck to the ground, makes apples fall, keeps the moon in orbit around the earth, and the earth around the sun.
And Newton's new laws enabled Halley to finally crack the puzzle of the second comet. It did follow the same laws as the planets, but its elliptical orbit was so long and thin that it appeared to travel in straight lines across the sky, disappearing and reappearing at intervals of months at a time.
Newton had unearthed a deep and fundamental truth about the world, that there are laws that govern the way things move, that gravity connects and pulls all objects together, and that mathematics is the key to all science.
It was the first provable, grand, unified theory of the entire universe.
10, 9, ignition sequence start.
60 seconds. Lights on.
Newton's laws of motion, his theory of gravity and his mathematics were the pinnacle of human thought for the next 2 centuries.
The Eagle has landed.
It's one small step for man.
They enabled us to put a man on the moon, and me into space.
One giant leap for mankind.
They allow us to reach out into the universe, to explain its intricate mechanism. But although he was the greatest genius of them all, Newton was indeed only standing on the shoulders of giants. And among those giants were Robert Hooke, Robert Boyle, Edmund Halley, and Christopher Wren. Together in the 17th century, they summoned science into being.
Robert Boyle went on to publish prolifically on natural philosophy. After his death, he endowed a series of lectures on the relationship between science and God.
Christopher Wren lived until he was 90, leaving an extraordinary legacy of buildings behind him. But there is also a monument to his astronomical obsession. A crater on the planet Mercury is named Wren in his honor.
Isaac Newton erased all acknowledgement of Robert Hooke from his Principia. He received a knighthood, became the president of the Royal Society and warden of the Royal Mint, where he was renowned for his cruelty towards forgers.
Robert Hooke lived and worked in the Royal Society until the end of his days. There are no surviving portraits of him. It is said that they were all destroyed by Newton.
And the young Edmund Halley? He became Astronomer Royal, and the comet whose course he'd so laboriously plotted was named after him. It will next cross our skies in 2061.
Next time, science moves from the abstract to the practical. From a handful to a roomful. Scientists begin saving lives, generating power, and enable man to fly. Together, they would start to transform the world.